happens is we're going to go from total sunshine to near total darkness in about an hour and 15 minutes.
From Texas to Maine, including parts of northern Vermont and New Hampshire, a total eclipse of the sun will be both a spectacular stellar event as well as a well-prepared for event.
When the sun goes out, the lights do not go out. That's our main objective.
John Gravelin runs control room operations for ISO New England. His team is responsible for balancing the supply and demand of electricity for Massachusetts and all of New England every minute of every day. And come this Monday, folks here in Holyoke will have a different sort of interest in the solar eclipse.
What's going to occur on that day is we're going to get a rapid decrease in the amount of production that our solar power plants are putting out on the system. We've done an extensive amount of preparation for this, and we're ready to manage our way through it.
John says weather will play a major role in the impact the eclipse will have on the solar power system. If it's a perfectly sunny and clear day, up to 6,000 megawatts of solar power could go offline during the eclipse.
6,000 megawatts is probably equivalent to five nuclear power stations. It's a lot of energy.
So with the possible temporary loss of all that power, ISO has implemented a contingency plan to replace it on a moment's notice.
We have batteries and pump storage, hydro facilities, and natural gas power plants that are fast start resources that we can bring on when we see the need.
John says if all goes well on their end, there should be no interruption to electrical service on the user's end.
The only way they should be able to tell there's an eclipse is by looking out their window and not seeing the sun.
When the eclipse begins, you can see in real time what impact it will have on the electric grid by visiting ISO's website. We do have a link for you on WCVB.com. I'm Doug Meehan, WCVB, News Center 5. So